Anything could happen, couldn't it?
Absolutely. Now, Ding Ding sort of has the fight of the tiger here, the eye of the tiger as well. Yesterday's loss was against Minnie Sue of Hong Kong, China. A 3-0 victory for Minnie Sue. Although Ding Ding did come back in the clutch and win her match after that. A little bit of a leg injury in the practice hall. Strong angles, Ding Ding right now on top of the bounce. She has the left-handed advantage. Now, a lot of people remember Miu Hirano in the Asian Championships saving many match points against Ding Ning to win the match in the fifth. But head-to-head, they've played 8 times, and Miu Hirano has only won 1 of those 8.
Yeah, and that was 2017 at the Asian Championships. The last time they played the China Open, Ding Ning won 4-1.
I just got chills starting to think about what if this goes into the third match and Japan is up 2-0. Just thinking about still how much work needs to be done. So when she won the Asian Championships, Miu Hirano was probably the most aggressive player I've ever seen. I mean, really early timing. Ito has early timing, Liu Shiwen has early timing, but Miu Hirano, more men or women, just was so early off the bounce, even on the receive.
All right, great angle there.
Right, again, the early timing takes it early enough because the wingspan of Ding Ning, she's got a handful of inches on Liu Shiwen. She's a bit taller than average. She's comfortable from behind the table. She's comfortable in the blocking and quick counter game as well. That's what makes her one of the most complete and most difficult to beat players in the women's game. Right on top of the bounce again, Hirano ties it up. Miu Hirano, it's like clockwork. I feel like she never misses a towel break. She's so formulaic, she has her routine. She's one of the most focused players I've seen, Jill.
Yeah, and she's still only 18. So what can she do in a few years' time? Perhaps 2020 Tokyo Olympics?
Well, that's the talk, right? I think with the Olympics coming up in Japan, there's been so much put in, so much resource poured into improving the national sport, improving a sport that they're already quite solid in. We've seen a lot of growth on both sides, although this tournament, the men, having been knocked out by Korea. Korea Republic, South Korea to a lot of the world. In terms of receive, Ding Ning, look at that flick. Keeps the racket head up. She could go either way. She could push if she wants. Quite aggressive, though, when she comes over the ball.
And that nice, slow, spinny one there. Variation, good to see. Ding Ning not quite getting over the ball to counter the spin.
When you're playing against the best players in the world, say the players from China, which happen to be the same, I think breaking rhythm is so important. The right idea for me. One deep push to the backhand, down the line forehand attempt.
Yeah, it was the right one to try. Only just slightly missed.
Chole. Slow motion there, Chole. Jill, you've been out there on the big stage before. Watching Miu Hirano, thinking about what's going on in her head, what do you imagine her brain is saying?
Well, I think she's got a tactic. She knows what she's going to do. She knows what serve she's going to, what she's going to follow up, depending on what the receive is. But, I mean, all the Japanese players are very, very calm, and you can see they're really focused on what they're doing.
Thank you. Ding Ning still gets a racket on that last one. This combination, I forgot in the beginning. I felt like there was a slow one from Yu Hirano. There it is, the soft, spinny, shallow one, and then the blast to the backhand corner. She even waits on the lob. Look at this ball, needs the side spin. Oh, okay. I think it was the foot that caught it right after the racket. Perfectly played point from Hirano. That's sort of what it has to be to get a point against Ding Ning, though.
Good placement.
Exchange here, Ding Ning keeping up with the pace. Only one time has Hirano taken advantage and finished the match successfully against Ding Ning, and not again since.
Yeah, that was a faster serve. She did then, followed in. Good counter topspin from both players.
Sits up a little bit, but it's deep on the table, and Ding Ning 11-6 takes game number one over Miu the Hurricane Hirano. The Queen of Hearts here with a variety of serves, hasn't even pulled out the reverse tomahawk serve, one of the most iconic serves in table tennis. And quite frankly, the only other player who does it at the world class level, it's not quite as spectacular as when Ding Ning does it.
To see when China played Sweden the other day, Ding Ning played Philippa Bergen, and then she obviously been watching Ding Ning, and she was doing the same serves. It was really quite funny to see.
Yeah, it's cool when you have the opportunity to play your hero or someone who's inspired you. For Tomokazu Harimoto beating Jun Mizutani, his idol. That's one thing, right? Getting to play is one thing, but beating the person you look up to while they're arguably at their prime, it's not like playing Waldner now, right? You're playing Mizutani at his prime. Now, we were touching on the fact that Liu Shiwen in 2010 was the last time she had lost in a World Team Championships. It was in the final. And she lost both of her singles matches, one to Feng Tianwei and one to Wang Yuegu. I sat next to both of them at a wedding not too long ago. It was something not to be talked about, of course. That wide wing, that backhand. You know, height-wise, I would imagine Miu Hirano's similar height, maybe slightly taller than Liu Shiwen. So it's not simply stature, speed, balance, weight transfer. These are all things that will improve for Hirano. Solid flick with that backhand, Jill.
Yeah, good angle. Stepped in well. You see it in the slow motion. Great angle out on the side of the table.
Had a softer shot, and I thought Ding Ning was going to seize the point. But Hirano played another aggressive one to follow. This is the one that I thought Ding Ning was going to capture the point. Hirano regains her balance and control of the point quickly to play it wide to the backhand. Ding Ning's receive game has been very solid. I think Hirano's serve was such a big factor in her victory at the Asian Championships 2017, but I think it's been heavily studied. The shovel serve, I feel like the Chinese women are reading better ever since. Just a reminder, the only woman from the Chinese national team's big four who did not fall victim to Miu Hirano was Liu Shiwen. In the timeout here for Miu Hirano's side. We'll see how long Miu Hirano extends this one. Corner to corner, covers blasts of shots. Hirano plays this so well. I mean, the angle of the racket has to be just right. People always say this is sped up in the replay. That was not. It's a fast backhand, Jill, that opening backhand.
It was, I think. Ding ding, you know, great serve, follow in. See what Hirano now can do with her serves. Oh, and she opened up well there with a forehand. Just kept a shorter serve. And then good angle.
Yeah,
down the line.
Right. I was going to say it's rare to see Ding Ning surprised, but for a moment, she didn't recognize that Miu Hirano was going wide to the forehand and was sort of backpedaling, stuck for a moment. Still a ways to go for Miu Hirano. Good pressure here on top of the bounce for the counter. You know, match points didn't scare her in 2017 at the Asian Championships. So being behind, I mean, this is less pressure than that in terms of score, but in terms of factor, in terms of the importance, the gravity of this title, this is the biggest tournament of the year. Good angle, wider and wider.
Yeah, good power there. She hits that forehand hard. Ding Ding coming in with those backhands.
I love
very
the
spinny.
The game face, Jill. Miu Hirano was known throughout Japan as being this adorable girl. But look at the game face.
She's given the evil eyes.
Oh, well anticipated. Ding Ding does not leave the backhand corner. The obvious choice there was to go to that backhand corner. A really risky shot to go the other way. Maybe one into the body would work here. Ding Ding, after all, is a slightly taller player than the last Chinese player, Liu Shiwen. So she does have a bigger middle. In fact, she has a middle. Top of the net here, Hirano within 2 points. Funny, the camera cut away so I couldn't see the apology situation, but we've seen a lot from both sides where normally you'd apologize, but the level of focus is just so high right now. There was a quick apology. You could see it for a moment. She showed the palm of the hand and turned it into a clenched fist. Little break off the top of the net again on the push. Ooh, that look. Ice cold. Reverse tomahawk. Just from the bounce of the ball, yep. The crowd oohed and awed, and she survived the reverse tomahawk.
It didn't seem to trouble her.
You know, I feel like it's like the ring. When you see it, you die. She brings it out and she survives, hangs in there, handles it well. This is the turning point for me. Being down 0-2 is very difficult in the final, let alone against the Queen of Hearts. She's got two serves on her side. Miu Hirano now tied up. The backhand, big point for Ding Ning. I think most of the world is watching this thinking, what does Miu Hirano have to do? Because if both players play their average game, Ding Ning wins. The real puzzle is, what does Miu Hirano have to do to pull off the upset? Game point to the Queen of Hearts on the receive. There she is. Played here, and the Hurricane ties it up at deuce now in game number two. Shovel serve. Middle to middle here from the middle of the table. That's the lowest percentage shot. It's the shortest shot on the table. Looks like we're gonna get a traditional pendulum serve here out of Ding Ning. Nice.
Left. Tunnel.
Great service there and follow up. You say great placement on the table.
It's a pretty bold ball from Ding Ning. With the opening backhand right down the line. It's that parallel. Now game point. Back to Ding Ning. This is the best response to the opening attack I've seen from Yu Hirano, and Ding Ning still has a better answer. She takes it 12-10 to secure a 2-0 lead. Strong bench there, Chun Meng and Wang Manyu. Any other nation in the world would have them in their lineup right now. That's the luxury. That's how deep China rolls. Outstanding points.
They don't come better than that, do they?
Simply spectacular. So fast. I'm watching. Hirano's really focused on the middle now. It was clear that that must have been the conversation. Ding Ning, no problem covering the middle, and finally one shot to go wide. Placement. Ding Ning does such a good job of holding her ground near the back of the table for such a tall player, Jill.
Yeah, I mean, she steps a little bit further away from the table, therefore that opens up the angles, but she's got height on her side, you know, long levers, legs and arms, so she's able to cover that ground. But then she steps in and plays a great backhand like that. So she's very versatile, close to the table and just a step back as well.
Cracking power here. Hirano looking, but not finding. So Ding Ning up 4-1 here. Love the lean on the serve. Beautiful forehand flick, the kill shot.
Yeah, picked that up really well. Nice short touch play there. Just a little bit high and she stepped in and flicked that forehand.
A lot of racket speed for someone who's hung out over the table.
Yeah, very wristy action.
Side out here to the widest corner. She has to be right on top of the bounce for this angle. As you mentioned, Ding Ning has the wing. Span, that is. Both wings, of course. Jeez. Is there anybody here who doesn't like Ding Ning? She's got the whole audience behind her. All right, down the line. Perfect shot from Yu Hirano. And it's the big stroke of Ding Ning that takes a little bit longer to recover from. She steps around that backhand corner and still almost gets a racket on this one.
Yeah, committed herself, but that was a beauty shot by Hirano.
In terms of home court advantage, I feel like the Chinese fans are so devoted, so there for their team. But it just seems like anywhere the Chinese national team plays, they have home court advantage. They are never alone. Oh, there he is with the glasses. Did you see him in the crowd? Groucho Marx glasses?
No, I missed him.
Oh, I'm sure you'll have your chance again. He pops up every once in a while. I wonder if anyone who's sitting next to him gets like a free hot dog or something. Good angle here right off the bounce again. Hirano extending her lead. What's this now, 5 in a row? She was down 1-4. And really, these patterns, it's just by rote, you know? You just snap them out. You see a combination open itself up, moves ahead in advance. You recognize when someone's off balance or out of position. But here, just a little bit flatter that slapped at.
It's a tomahawk serve. Strong third ball. Always know when she's going to do it because she bounces the ball on the floor.
Right. And from time to time we see just the straight tomahawk serve, but usually it's the reverse tomahawk. But I think the thing is, for Ding Ning, she can play it soft and spinny half long. She can play it long and spinny. A variety of side spins and top spins. I mean, it's so unpredictable. A lot of players really don't read it so well, but Hirano very well rehearsed. Second towel break, leading by two with the serves. Ooh, it looked like she considered turning for a moment and said, no, I'm gonna stay backhand on this, drops the head of the racket and loads it with spin. If you're a little newer to table tennis, you wonder why she just breathed on her racket. She was fogging it up, a little moisture to wipe the dust off the top sheet for maximum traction and grip, spin. Right down the middle here, on top of the bounce. There he is, that's the close-up we wanted. It might have been Shock G from Digital Underground, that or Groucho Marx, we'll see. Miu Hirano right now, though, is all business. No funny stuff out here for Miu Hirano.
No, she played those angles well and then into the body.
It's much like Mima Ito, this high-risk, off-the-bounce play. Even that last ball, there was so much racket speed, it was fast, just stopped by the net.
Yeah, very risky shot.
She got right into it with the long push on the receive, too. Ding ding.
Backhand there. She's on the diagonal and then straight down the line.
Yeah. I feel like Ding Ning with the racket up over the table, she doesn't show, it's just that she shows it with the racket slightly open and then at the last moment says, guess what, you have to deal with an attack. Surprise.
Oh, lovely. She anticipated that well. Ding Ning stepped in.
Was it 9-5? It must have been 9-6 before. I just can't remember if there was a 4-point lead at one point. Either way, Ding Ning right back. 9-8. Just 1 point down, a second serve here. Miu Hirano's been through this drill before. 2017, saved match points. Came back from down. She looked like she got caught out of position for a moment. The ball before seemed to surprise her. Watch the placement on Ding Ning's opening shot right at the baseline. Miu Hirano just trying to recover with that wrist bent way back. Didn't seem the same after that moment. Perfect opening placement from Ding Ning. Now she has the serves on her side with the crowd ever present. That's the word I was going to use, the speed here. It's just back and forth so fast. Hirano has taken some risks. This game, she was way ahead. And
she
Ding Ning.
9-5 up.
That's what I was thinking. So now Ding Ning with match point on her serve. Beautiful shot right on the line here. This is risky. Again, fearless. Sometimes the tighter it gets, the bolder you need to go. And an odd combination, too. She plays the backhand from the forehand side, steps around and plays it wide. So one match point saved, and now the serve back with the hurricane and the ice cold stare. The eye of the hurricane. Ooh. First time we've seen a receive that gave such a third ball to Hirano. Let's watch one more time. Good contact, light top and side spin. Just very subtle contact from Hirano. It's funny, fine margins in the receive, but if it sits up a little, it makes a world of difference. So game point to Hirano. Oh, tried the strawberry. First time we've seen it. I was actually wondering if this is something we would see. If she can make this shot, it can be very effective in breaking things up, but it's...
Seemed a bit half-hearted.
Right.
Didn't really commit herself.
Right. And on a deeper serve, it's a little bit tougher, too, to play with authority. So back tied up at 11 each serve on the Hurricane side. Well played right into the middle. Ding Ding with that backhand over the table is dangerous. And it's match point once again for the Queen of Hearts and Team China. Wow, look at that. Please, please, please in the front, hands together. Zhongguo Dui.
They've got hearts on their cheeks as well with the flag.
And she takes it, Ding Ding. The flags and the hearts pay off. The fans get what they want. Ding Ding ties it up, a 3-0 victory.